This morning, the hunt is on. Dozens of law enforcement officers on the search. Dozens of schools are on alert, and an entire community is on edge as a manhunt in Tennessee intensifies. More than 31 hours after a gunman killed four people and wounded several others at a Waffle House in the Nashville area, the suspect is still on the run today, and police fear he is still armed. But one weapon he does not have on him, the AR-15 semi-automatic rifle that police believe he used in the killings. That is because one man in the restaurant, James Shaw, actually wrestled the gun away, and police say likely prevented more carnage because of it. Listen.
And it was at that time that I kind of made up my mind, because there's no way to lock that door, that if it was going to come down to it, he was going to have to work to kill me. You have to either react or you're gonna, you know, fold. And I chose to react because I didn't see any other way of me, you know, living. And that's all I wanted to do. I just wanted to live.
But still, folks are calling him a hero today. CNN's Nick Valencia is live with the very latest from Tennessee. So, Nick, the hunt is still on. The suspect has a really disturbing history. What do we know about him and where the search stands right now?
Yeah, hey there, Kate. It's really scary when you listen to James Shaw Jr. and think about the situation that those folks were in at the Waffle House yesterday, if not for the actions of James Shaw Jr., who told a local affiliate that he was just thinking about his four-year-old little girl the whole time, that he was trying to save himself, and in the process, no doubt, saved a lot of others. We were supposed to get an update just a little while ago from the Nashville Police Department about this manhunt, the Dragnet, about 80 police officers from Nashville working with ATF, FBI, as well as other agencies to try to find this individual. So far, Kate, though, no credible sightings of Travis Reinking, 29 years old, the man accused of walking into this Waffle House behind me early Sunday morning, killing four people and injuring several others, two of which are still in the hospital. Local schools here are also on lockout, not allowing any visitors or guests into or off of the campus because this alleged killer is still on the run. Kate?
And Nick, what do we know about the victims? What are we learning about them?
Well, the four victims, those that perished here early Sunday morning, were all in their 20s, being identified as Taurine Sunderland, Joe Perez, Akila De Silva, and De'Ebony Groves. We also know two others are still in the hospital in stable condition. And you asked me initially, Kate, about the history of this alleged gunman. We know in 2017 that he walked into a restricted area in the White House and told Secret Service that he wanted to meet with President Trump. He was arrested, and because of that, the FBI recommended that he be taken, his guns be taken away from him in the home state of Illinois. But when he moved to the Nashville area in the fall of 2017, Travis Reinking's father gave those weapons back to Reinking, and it's believed that he used that AR-15, one of the weapons that was seized in this mass shooting that happened early Sunday evening. He's a man with a history of mental health problems. In 2016, he told police he believed that the pop singer Taylor Swift was stalking him. He also is said to have heard voices and believed that people were hacking his phone and looking at his computers. There's been a $2,500 reward offered for information leading to his arrest, but right now, at this hour, Kate, he's still on the run.
Sure is. Nick, thank you so much. A lot of moving parts here, so let's discuss this right now. Joining me is CNN law enforcement analyst and former assistant director of the U.S. Marshals Service, Art Roderick. Art, thanks for coming in.
Hi, Kate.
So this guy shot up a Waffle House without wearing clothes, and he's clearly unbalanced. Are you surprised that law enforcement hasn't picked him up yet?
I am, if he's still alive. I mean, I keep going back to the 2016 report where he told first responders, this was the Taylor Swift report, where he told first responders that he was, you know, suicidal. So is this a product of what's come out of this particular incident? It could very well be. It wouldn't be unusual for an individual to commit a crime like this and then kill themselves. And we have documented history of him being suicidal, plus also seven different police reports of some sort of paranoia, some definitely mental issues going on here. So we've got a history here, and it wouldn't surprise me that at some point after the shooting at the Waffle House that he went ahead and committed suicide. Now, having said that, there's obviously a very good possibility that he's still out there, hunkered down in the woods somewhere. But I think when you look at this weather issue that's been going on for a couple of days in Nashville, they had all rain all day yesterday, mid-50s temperature last night. You know, is he able to survive out there with just pants on and shirtless in that type of weather?
Right. Can you take us all on the ground right now? What are your former colleagues in the Marshals Service doing right now to find him?
You know, all law enforcement, they've gridded out that area behind the apartment complex. They're looking at abandoned dwellings, old shacks, any place possibly where he could find some kind of shelter. They're also checking any types of crimes in the area, breaking and enterings, carjackings, auto thefts. And they're also trying to pinpoint from the air, as well as on the ground, any possible location that he could have traveled in via canine dogs, tracking dogs, and also from the air. So there's a lot going on here. There's been reports issued earlier that people have seen law enforcement in a straight line walking through backyard areas in this wooded mm-hmm. area behind the apartment complex. So the manhunt is still going on in earnest.
And the fact that this many hours afterward, there have been no credible sightings of him, what does that tell you?
It leads me to believe that there's a good possibility that this individual might have killed himself. I mean, okay. I keep going back to that, but I think he doesn't. We haven't seen any history in his background of him being able to be a survivalist type, an individual that could right. survive in the woods for any extended period of time. So it's just odd that there's been no confirmed sighting of him since yesterday morning after he left his apartment complex in that wooded area behind there.
Hunt is on in the community, still on edge, yes. waiting for something to give. Art, thank you so much.